Hello everyone, this is Ahmet Çetinkaya. I would like to introduce the Innovative Global Program in the College of Engineering at Shibaura Institute of Technology. The Innovative Global Program, IGP, was established in 2020 October. It provides a research-focused engineering education in English language, and IGP students, when they graduate, they obtain the degree of Bachelor of Engineering. Every year, around 9 new students enroll in IGP, and IGP belongs to the College of Engineering at Shibaura Institute of Technology, as I mentioned. Shibaura Institute of Technology is a private university, and it was founded in 1927 as an education and research environment respecting the spirit of the Monozukuri culture. And it has the goal of developing student skills for career success in job markets across the globe. Shibaura Institute of Technology has 2 campuses, Toyosu campus in Tokyo and the Omiya campus in the Saitama Prefecture. Students of IGP take courses mainly in the Toyosu campus, but IGP professors have research laboratories both in Toyosu and Omiya campuses. IGP has a very special curriculum structure, and it is interesting to compare the curriculum map of IGP with that of a conventional engineering program. As shown on the left, students of conventional engineering programs take courses in the first 3 years of their education, and then in their 4th year they do research for a graduation thesis project. In IGP, the structure is quite different. IGP students start their research from their 1st year, they do hands-on research for 4 years, and they do this while taking many advanced engineering courses, as well as courses in natural sciences, mathematics, computer science, humanities, and so on. I will go over the academic life of a student in IGP. So IGP students join a research laboratory from their very 1st year. They start doing research and learning about doing research, but they also start taking courses in mathematics, physics, chemistry, computer science, humanities, physical education, Japanese language, and so on. They continue doing research in their laboratory in their 2nd year. They also continue taking courses, but from 2nd year, they can also start taking courses that are specialized to their own field. What is also important is that IGP students can visit different laboratories. This is the lab rotation scheme. They visit these different laboratories to learn about various fields of science and engineering. They learn about different research approaches as well. In their 3rd year, IGP students start working on their graduation research projects at an accelerated pace. They devote more energy in their research, but at the same time, they can continue taking specialized courses and they can attend career-related seminars for job seeking. In their 4th year, many IGP students already have research results that can be presented in international conferences. IGP students also have the opportunity to participate in overseas university exchange programs. After graduation, IGP students have a special opportunity to progress to the graduate school at SIT, but they can also receive individual support for career plans in Japan or overseas, so they may start working even right after graduation. What is the research-based learning at IGP like? So as I mentioned, IGP students join a research laboratory from their 1st year. Basically, when they enroll in IGP, they are assigned a laboratory and a supervisor. This is based on their choice, and they are also assigned 2 advisors. These advisors can be from different fields, and this allows students to gain experience in several fields, and it encourages them for multidisciplinary research. Students of IGP do hands-on research for 4 years, and they present their research findings every semester in presentation sessions attended by IGP professors. For graduation, IGP students must earn at least 124 credits, but 64 of these credits come from research work in their laboratories. So other credits are from coursework for taking classes. IGP offers a variety of courses and all in English. Students take basic courses in mathematics like calculus, linear algebra, probability and statistics. They can take physics courses like basic physics, optics, mechanics, chemistry courses like basic and general chemistry and instrumental analysis. They can take computer science courses like computer programming, web design and computer networks. They take communication and humanities courses like academic writing and engineering ethics. They can also take physical education courses, advanced engineering courses, specialized courses to learn their fields in depth. And towards their graduation, they can also take graduate level courses. Of course, throughout their studies, IGP students can take Japanese language courses in several different levels. Also, IGP offers so-called global project-based learning courses, and these are courses where students collaborate with students from abroad on projects. They are sometimes conducted abroad in other countries, and students who are interested can visit those countries and take the courses there. An interesting aspect of the education in IGP is the so-called lab rotation. IGP students from their second year, they can experience research in different laboratories. In the lab rotation scheme, they visit four different laboratories to learn about different research fields. They visit each laboratory for 7 weeks, and this allows students to learn a lot about different research methodologies and various approaches in different fields. Let's look at the IGP admission process. So those who want to apply to IGP have two opportunities for admission, and the applications for the first opportunity typically starts around November. The second opportunity applications start around March of the following year. There are several steps in this process, and applicants are first asked to submit several documents. And the first step is the document screening. The applications or applicants who pass the screening are invited to take mathematics, physics, and chemistry exams, and they are asked to attend online interviews with the IGP faculty members. And finally, successful applicants, around 9 of them, will enroll in IGP in the October of next year, and they will start their education. There is more information about IGP admissions at the website given here, igp.shibaoura.it.ac.jp. And we also have another website called IGP Explore with the address given here. It has a lot of information about the IGP activities and the research laboratories in IGP. Research laboratories in IGP do research in several different fields, and these are the fields of applied chemistry, computer science, biomedical engineering, material science, mechanical engineering, and engineering education. In the remaining part of this video, you will learn more about these fields, and IGP professors and IGP members will present about their research and education activities in their laboratories.
My research area is mainly development of new materials and hydrogel polymers, network polymers like ionic gels, shape memory polymers, and nanocomposite materials. And I also develop these type of materials with the help of 3D printing and synthesize them to understand their design-based functionalities. To use these materials in the engineering scope and engineering field, I want to understand their design-based functionalities to explore them in more task-specific applications.
Hello, I'm Sharul Mohammadan. Today I would like to share with you about the Welfare and Human Engineering Laboratory. At our laboratory, the philosophy is to support human through development, enhancement, and application of technology such as assistive and medical devices so that we can improve the health and quality of life. In order to join this lab, you need to have a basic math and physics knowledge, and along the way, you will need the design, mechatronic, modeling, simulation, artificial intelligence, and also virtual reality knowledge depends on your research. Example of research conducted in this laboratory are home-based upper limited rehabilitation, club foot device, corrective and maintenance phases, and human musculoskeletal modeling and simulation. I think that's it, a bit about my lab. Thank you very much.
Hello, this is System Software Laboratory of Computer Science major in the Innovative Global Program. Our lab is directed by the main supervisor Professor Midori Sugaya and the substantive supervisor assistant professor Tiporn Lau Hocking Wanwit. The research themes of our lab includes effective computing, Kansei engineering, the processing of biological signals such as brainwave, heart rate, and eye tracking, and the use of data science and AI techniques to model those data. We are applying these knowledge in various aspects, especially human behavior and emotion analysis, user-friendly design and evaluation, as well as healthcare applications. These are some research topics conducted by the IGP students in our lab. We develop emotion-aware systems that respond to human emotions captured by biosensors such as brainwave and pulse sensors through robots' facial expressions, voice, and so on. In addition, we apply data science techniques to develop a personalized travel recommendation system based on user preferences obtained from online texts and images such as Instagram. These are some research papers at international conferences by our lab students. We are looking forward to your contribution. Come join us.
Hello everyone, this is Ahmet Çetinkaya from Stochastic Systems and Control Laboratory. In our lab, we do research on many topics in the fields of control engineering, communication systems, machine learning, and applied probability. For example, we do extensive research on network control and Internet of Things. Especially, we are interested in cybersecurity issues, and we design randomized communication protocols to achieve secure sensing and control. Recently, we have also been working on automated driving systems, and we took part in the development of an award-winning tool that finds failures in lane-keeping systems of self-driving cars. Finally, we are also interested in data-driven and learning-based control. We We would like to design a controller for a self-balancing robotic system directly by using the data generated by applying randomized inputs to the system. If you are interested in machine learning, AI, and data-driven control, check our website.
Hi, I'm Jimmy Ames, and this is the Philosophy of Science Laboratory. Now, you might be thinking, what does philosophy have to do with science? Actually, it has a lot to do with science, and they're closely interconnected. In our lab, you'll learn to think about both science in general and specific topics in science from a philosophical perspective. Have you ever wondered about what is space and time? Why is it that we can move in any direction in space, but only in one direction in time? Namely the future direction. Again, why is it that seemingly complex patterns emerge from simple rules, not only in nature, but also in computer simulations and machine learning systems? In our lab, we seek answers to questions like these by taking the results of modern science as our point of departure. If you like to ponder about the deep questions, or if you just like thinking about the basic concepts of theoretical physics, mathematics, or logic, come join our lab.
So in each laboratory, we have a laboratory that can conduct physics in multiple extreme conditions. We can explore the phenomena from the temperature of 300 Kelvin or room temperature down to 0.3 Kelvin. Remember that the temperature in the outside vacuum in the space is about 3 Kelvin. And we also can explore the physics in the pressure region from 0 to 3 gigapascal and in the external magnetic field up to 16 Tesla. This is the picture of the organic crystal. This is actually an organic superconductor. So as you can see here, we can do the organic crystal synthesis, we can do the resistivity measurement, we can do the magnetization measurement under pressure, under external field, and also we can do the microscopic experiment measurement, so-called muon spin relaxation. So in this case, we will use the large facility accelerator base to study a material.
Hello, my name is Paolo Mele, and my laboratory is Sinfin Laboratory at Shibara IT on Mia campus. The main topic of my research is thermoelectric thin films fabricated by pulse laser deposition, PLD. The merit of thermoelectrics is that they can directly convert heat in electricity, and nowadays there is a lot of waste heat to convert. The thermoelectrics can convert waste heat in a wider range of temperatures, and the generated power can be used to power sensors and devices out of the grid, which is a great merit. However, conventional thermoelectric modules are difficult to use because they are bulky, brittle, and based on toxic, expensive elements. In my research, I aim to develop modules based on thermoelectric thin films, which are sustainable, cheap, and flexible. This is the main topic of my research. There are several others. So if you are interested to join, you are welcome. And for further information, you can check this link. That's all from me. So thank you for your kind attention.
Hello, I'm Naomi Sakai, organizing a high-functional materials laboratory. Currently, my laboratory is researching on high-temperature bulk superconductors and their high magnetic field applications. Melt process rare BCO bulk superconductor can trap strong magnet field and make strong magnet, then permanent magnet, and stable levitation is also possible. In our laboratory, we use several techniques such as structure crystal growth, microstructure control, and superconduct joining to improve the performance of bulk superconductors. We are also studying about applications to a new type of portable compact NMR analytical devices. We are also studying about application to magnetic separation, which will be available for the removal of impurities from solutions and for material recycling. Please visit us. Thank you for listening.
Hello, my name is Ayako Yamamoto. I pressure science laboratory in Shibaura Institute of Technology. We are studying a functional inorganic materials. Let's enjoy material hunting with us.
We use this high pressure machine, which can apply the pressure of up to 4 GPa to sample. This machine plays an important role in the development of new material, because it allows us to produce samples that could not be produced under ambient pressure.
The material is synthesized by mixing fine metal oxide. High entropy stabilized phases can be obtained by quenching from 1000 degrees Celsius. It is expected as functional materials by using high entropy stabilized effect.
A superconductor is a material that has zero electrical resistance at low temperature. Furthermore, as shown in this, it can levitate and hold magnet in place, and it used for transportation and other applications.
慎重に歩めばいい真実なんてもう遠くの塔に知っていること知らないだけでしょあれほど刻んだ 後悔も繰り返す毎日の中で書き消されていくのね。まっさらになった決意を